Greetings, Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher, formulator of the CanXida range of dietary supplements. Thanks again for looking at my video. I really do appreciate all my subscribers, and it's for you guys I make these videos. So if you're not a subscriber, then subscribe. Right, question. What health issues or diseases can Candida cause? Well, this is a very interesting question, and the reply to this is quite simple. It can cause a wide range of dysfunction in the body. And this is where medical people think people like me need to get their head examined or be on serious psychotic, antipsychotic medication because they think that I'm absolutely crazy. Or maybe I am crazy. I don't think I'm crazy. I'm not that crazy. When you think about something like Candida albicans or many different types of Candida strains, when you think about bacteria, when you think about viruses and parasites and lots of different potential pathogens, they can cause a big, big problem for one reason, is they throw the balance of the body right out. They make the person's immune system go crazy. Now, your immune system has an incredibly powerful effect on nearly all aspects of your body, your body's well-being. But one of the biggest things I see with Candida, what health issues it can cause long-term a serious dysfunction with the person, how that person views their life. When you've been sick for a long time, like I was, for example, in my 20s, I got very, very unwell for a long period of time. When you go from doctor to doctor and you're told that you're nuts, you're crazy, you're a hypochondriac, when your parents don't believe you anymore, when your partner leaves you, when your kids think you're completely bonko, when all of the doors slam shut in your face, when you've been on all the drugs, you've been to all the doctors, and you've got no answers to your health, how do you think it makes you feel? Okay? What kind of disease do you think that causes? It causes you to give up hope. It causes you to really question why you're bloody well alive. Many people I've seen over the years with a serious yeast imbalance have contemplated suicide. They don't want to live anymore. And one of the big reasons why they don't want to live anymore is because nobody believes in them anymore. They even start to give up believing in themselves. That's the sort of diseases you can get and imbalances from a bad yeast infection. Okay. But when it comes to disease, diagnosable disease, I would say it can cause many, many different types of signs and symptoms. Now remember, signs are what I, the physician, can see in you. Symptoms is what you experience. So a sign is more subjective, and the symptom is subjective because that's what you're feeling. So many different signs and symptoms can occur with this based on how the yeast infection, in fact, causes the immune imbalance. But not just the immune imbalance. Candida will also create a big problem with other things in your body, beneficial bacteria and other bacteria. It will cause imbalance. Good bacteria can go bad to nasty with a Candida infection. Beneficial bacteria can go to low to zero with a bad yeast infection. And that can increase your risk of many different diseases when the beneficial bacteria go down the gurgler. Beneficial bacteria now are linked to even cancer prevention. We know that people with bowel cancer have very compromised levels of beneficial bacteria. We know that most people with cancers have got significant amounts of yeast in their body. There's a lot of American and Italian research in particular. There's a huge amount of work in this area. Nearly all cancer patients are loaded with yeast infection. Am I saying that Candida causes cancer? No, I never said that, did I? But what I'm saying is there's a correlation between them both. There's a correlation between many, many autoimmune diseases and yeast infection. So we know that when people have got these serious illnesses, that Candida seems to sit there alongside, okay? It's just like when there's a big fire. We know that usually a fire truck turns up. But did the fire truck cause a fire? Not really, but there's association between them both. So, therefore, what we can infer from that it's very important to get rid of a yeast infection, to get the balance back again, to restore harmony in the body, to make sure there are lots of beneficial bacteria that keep these bad, nasty yeast imbalances, you know, from going crazy. That's what we can infer from that. The Candida can be not necessarily responsible or causing these diseases, but it can certainly create a massive imbalance in the body, leading you towards this kind of a sickness. Now remember, I never said that Candida can cause all these illnesses, but certainly can contribute to it. Okay, there's a big difference there. So I hope that answers your question. It's very important to determine, A, do you have that Candida imbalance, and B, if you've got one, to deal with it. Now remember, I've said this before, over 50% of people I see now in my clinic, my online clinic, in fact, when I test them, have got no Candida at all. They've got bad bacteria or low beneficial bacteria or parasites. And there are many people who never thought they have got Candida, in fact, have got Candida. When I've done a stool test, I found Candida, and they didn't believe it. But the microscope didn't lie. The yeast culture didn't lie. So just be careful before you make an assumption that you've got a yeast infection. You first need to know the facts, okay? Don't jump to conclusions. Many people do that on the internet. It's a crazy thing to do. So many health issues and diseases can be implicated with Candida. Don't forget that. So I hope that gives you a bit of an insight, you know, into my reply to that question. If you haven't got my report, please click on the link in the description box. And don't forget to subscribe. And please, if you want to have some more video topics, contact me through my Candida Crusher channel through YouTube. Thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it.